Okay, so this week we're starting to see the first batch of fine tunes of Mistral come out. And one of the ones that has just come out in the past few hours that I think is very special is this Mistral Orca. So this model surprised me very much at how good it actually is. So let's have a look at this. So this is basically Mistral Orca 8K. It is trained up from the people who've created the Open Orca data set and models. And this is a fine tune of the Mistral 7 billion parameter model. And it really is amazing. So it's basically trained on a curated subset of GPT-4 data based around the Orca paper. I've talked about this in some of the videos before. And they're claiming that it beats pretty much all but one of the 13 billion models, or all but one of all the models below 30 billion that are actually on Hugging Face. So they've put up some evaluation stuff about this. We can see that, okay, when you compare it to a bunch of the other models that they've done themselves, which it seems to be getting better. And those models are 13 billion parameter models. So it really does show that getting a really good base model enables you to do fine tuning that improves the model so much. So you can see here, I guess this is taking on their epochs as they've been going and training it. It's doing very well on a number of these particular dataset challenges that the Hugging Face leaderboard uses. I would have liked to seen, you know, what scores it's getting on GSM 8K, but I don't actually see that in here. They've also benchmarked it against some of the other common benchmarks, such as AGI Eval and Big Bench, and it seems to perform really well at doing this. So let's jump into the code, and I'll show you the results that I got, which really surprised me of just how well this model performs. Okay, so I'm just bringing in the model itself, and they have a new system for doing the prompts. So they mentioned this, that this is actually taken from this ChatML format, you know, that originated with OpenAI here. So it does seem like a number of them are adopting this, which is good if we can get sort of one standard thing. They've got the prompt format here. I actually found that to get the best results, I needed to change this a little bit by putting in a space between here and system. And the way that I found that was by using this prompt. Even when I was using this prompt, the model seemed to want to predict that space coming up there. And then once I changed to that, it turned out to get better results as well. So, okay, I've set up basically a simple system where you can pass in a system prompt, an input text. If you're using the system prompt, it'll wrap it correctly. Like I said, I've added this space here, and I basically join these two prompts and then remove them from the generation output at the end. All right, so code generation. Here, there's probably not a huge change to what, you know, the previous one was getting in what I noticed. I really wasn't trying to do a lot of code generation to test it on that, but I encourage you to, you know, go and do that. I was impressed, though, that it could describe sort of what the code was doing, you know, that kind of thing, quite nicely. Where I was impressed, though, was with these instruction answering. And as I played with it more, I realized that it really responds to the system prompt probably a lot better than a lot of other models that are out there. So here again, this is from the Phi paper, or the Phi 1.5 paper. And we can see that it's doing a nice, you know, generation for this. But I find it's interesting how when it's asked to do step by step, it literally writes out step by step for these things. So one of the ones that stood out was the normal question I ask it about llamas, vicunas, alpacas, etc. And you can see that it sort of got a variety of things that were different. And then step by step, it went through in point form. And this model, particularly with the system prompt that they use in here, does seem to like to do things in point form. So I wondered at first, okay, is this just everything is going to be point form? But no, when you basically change it, or give it something that wouldn't be point form, it actually can adapt quite easily. So here it's still doing sort of like, I guess in some ways it's still a point form, but it's actually got it into different paragraphs. And this is where I started to realize, okay, the strength of this model, in that not only can it write, you know, a nice email and stuff like that, it can really adopt the sort of personality that you give it in the system prompt. So for example, I gave it the exact same input prompt, but now I said, okay, you are Freddie, a young five-year-old boy who is scared AI will end the world, write only with the language of a young child. And sure enough, it does a very good job. You know, it mentions that, hey, my name's Freddie. I'm 5 years old. I've heard about GPT-4 and I'm a little scared. You can imagine that this being from a young child. So I realized that this is actually picking up at the system prompt very nicely in here as it goes through these things. Another one that I wanted to try again with the exact same input prompt about writing the email. But now I said, okay, you're Kate, the vice president of USA. You're against regulatory capture and like to explain that, right? So here we get a much more official sort of letter. We've still got, I guess, these sort of point forms for the paragraphs, but we've definitely got a much more official sort of letter. I'm writing you to express my concerns regarding the potential risks of regulatory capture and advocate for the open source release of GPT-4. The generation here is very impressive. We can see the speeds are quite nice too on this. If you want it to be succinct, you can do that. So here I've basically just taken their one. I've left in their stuff. And I was worried that all of them were going to need this Alignment Lab AI if that was trained into it sort of forceful in, but it seems that it isn't. It's not. I can, you know, write out your short answer and be succinct. Sure enough, the capital of England is London. Now, if you play with that and ask it for, you know, step by step and stuff like that, it will give you a much more detailed answer. I ask it a question about Geoffrey Hinton. Can Geoffrey Hinton and George Washington, you know, have a conversation? Here we can see that not only does it give us the answer of no at the end, but it's able to then, you know, go through the logic. It actually gets getting this correct. I think Hinton was born in 47 or certainly around then, certainly a lot better than some of the other models have said in relation to this. And we can see that it's going through point by point and then gives us a nice answer at the end. All right, what about storytelling? So if, you know, one of the challenges, if we've got a model that's just going to do everything in one way, can it actually be a good storyteller? So I've basically said, you're a MistralOrca, a genius storyteller, write your story with details and make it compelling. I'm leaving out words here. And you can see that it comes up with a nice name for the koala called Mr. Fluffles. And it's got a whole story about Mr. Fluffles and it, you know, it goes through and it highlights the incredible skills of Mr. Fluffles. That's, again, very impressive. What about continuing a conversation and answering that? Again, this did pretty nicely as well. Okay, so the last one that I wanted to test would be the GSM 8K. Now, remember, Mistral 7 itself didn't do very well with these. We can see our question about apples. It does a really nice job of doing sort of chain of thought reasoning, getting things out, and then giving us the correct answer at the end. What about for the babysitter, right? So here we've got, you know, she earns $12 an hour. She did it for 50 minutes. So here we've got a whole sort of breakdown of this and we've got the correct answer at the end. So we've got, you know, $10 for this. The final one, it doesn't seem to do as well, but it certainly is getting closer than they were before. So this is something that, you know, I think it's interesting. I'd love to see the benchmarks on the whole GSM 8K and see how this model actually does. So anyway, load it up, have a play with it. Let me know what you think about it in the comments. I think it's a really impressive model and it's one of the sort of first fine tunes that I've played with for this Mistral 7B. It's certainly outperforming a lot of models that are a lot bigger than it. Anyway, as always, if you've got questions, put them in the comments below. If you found this video useful, please click like and subscribe, share it with people, etc. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.